7. Welcome back to the physics class once again. So what we are going to do today, we are going to do some of the new numerals of density, and before that we are going to talk a bit about some additional information regarding the density. Okay, so let's get started with the first one, where you can see that the density of water, what is the density of water at 4 degree centigrade? Now the density of water at 4 degree centigrade, when it comes to the CGS system, okay, so here I am writing it down, CGS system, we have already known about what is CGS and SI system, right? So in case of CGS system, that is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Now what stands for, when anybody or when the question happens like what 1 gram per centimeter, the density of water at 4 degree centigrade is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Now explain this stuff. How you are going to explain this? So listen this very carefully. 1 gram is the mass, right? And per centimeter cube means 1 centimeter cube. Okay. So how we are going to break this down? The mass of water having 1 centimeter cube volume is 1 gram at 4 degree centigrade. Okay, now how you are going to explain this? The mass of water at 1 gram of water having 1 centimeter cube volume, the water, the mass of water that is occupying 1 centimeter cube volume, if a volume is taken where all the length, breadth and height, if we are taking what is a volume, 1 length, 1 breadth and 1 volume or 1 height basically, so it all occupies that cube, right? Centimeter cube, 1 centimeter in length, 1 centimeter in breadth, 1 centimeter in height, multiplication of all three gives 1 centimeter cube of a volume. Got it? So the mass that is occupying that 1 centimeter cube, 1 centimeter cube will be 1 gram at what temperature? 4 degree centigrade. Okay? Now similarly, when we are going to explain this term, 1000 kg per meter cube, that is in SI system, how we are going to represent that? In a similar manner, the mass of water having 1 meter cube volume is 1000 kg at 4 degree centigrade, right? Now apart of that, this density of water in CGS system or in SI system, this is maximum, this is the maximum density of water at 4 degree centigrade. Now when the temperature of water has been reduced from 4 degree to 0 degree, or it has been increased or raised above 4 degree centigrade, the density of water gets reduced. Understand? So the maximum density of water is at 4 degree centigrade, that is also 1 gram per centimeter cube in CGS, and in SI that is 1000 kg per meter cube. Alright, now when we are talking about the effect of heat on density, what is the effect of heat on density? How we are going to determine? We have already gone through how heat affects the mass, how heat affects the expansion of solid, how the volume is getting affected. Now this is the time for density. We have to know about how this heat is going to affect it. So here, before knowing the effect of density, we have to know, we know that density is equals to mass per volume, right? So how this mass is getting affected? Now on alteration of heat or temperature, this mass remains pretty constant. Okay, so no alteration happens in case of mass, but volume alters. how this volume is going to alter. Now, if you remember that with the increase of heat or increase in temperature, the volume increases, right? So, with the increase in heat, the volume increases, and with the decrease in or cooling, the volume decreases of any substance. Okay, so let's write that how we are going to, how the change in density is going to happen. So, increase in temperature. Increase in temperature results in the volume increase, right? So simultaneously, as you can see that density is equals to mass per volume. Now, when the mass is pretty constant, so how the density is going to be affected? When the volume is increasing with the increase in temperature, the density will decrease, right? Because a volume is in the denominator position, right? So on the increase in volume, the density of a substance decreases when the mass remains constant. Understand? Now with the contrary, decrease in temperature, exactly the opposite phenomena will take place. The volume will decrease or shrink and the density will increase. Take an example of any kind of like, take the example of iron. Okay, so on heating, iron expands, right? We have already known that. Now on expansion, the density or the compactness within the molecule, that is the molecules are closely compact among each other, right? So it gets, with the application of heat, the intermolecular space increases among them. So with that, what happens? With that, the density of a molecule decreases, right? So here, with the decrease in temperature, volume will decrease and the density increases and the mass remain constant. After that, so we have understand the relation between the density, mass and volume and the effect of heat on density, right? Now after that, how this heat is going to affect the solid, liquid and gas here. Now this effect is pretty varies among the solids and the liquid and gases. Okay, so in case of solid, what happens? In case of solid, the expansion of volume is pretty low. Expansion of volume or the change in volume, increase in volume is low, right? So here the expansion is also or we can say the effect of heat on density of the solid is also pretty low. And in case of, but in case of liquid and gas, liquid and gas, this volume alters rapidly. Change in volume high. Here it will be change in volume is low in case of solid, and in case of liquid and gas, change in volume is pretty high. So as their density change will be, density will be changing in a low manner in case of solid, while in case of liquid and gas, density change is high. Now, coming back to the numericals. Okay, let's start doing that. I have taken example number 6, where it is said a piece of silver of volume 10 centimeter cube has a mass of 103 grams. Find the density of the silver. Now you have to see from here what is given to you. So the volume is given, mass is given. So you already know from there density is equals to m by v, that is mass per volume.
Now, first you write what is given. Volume is given. So, volume is equals to 10 centimeter cube. And again, mass is given. Mass is equals to 103 gram. So, putting the value of the volume and the mass in the formula will get. So, here mass is 103 gram and volume is 10. So, after dividing, we'll get a value of 10.3 and put the unit gram per centimeter cube. So, this is the value of the density of silver. Okay, now after that, coming to the example number 7. Here, what is said, 30 centimeter cube of iron weighs 234 gram. So, the volume is given and the mass is given again. Find the density of the iron in kg per meter cube. Now, this is the catch. Okay. So, first what we have to do, we don't have to think about converting kg per meter cube in first place. First, we have to find out the density in the CGS system. Then, we'll convert it into the kg per meter cube. Okay. So, first we'll write what is given. So, the volume is given, that is 30 centimeter cube. Again, the mass is 234 grams. Okay. Now, put the values of volume in the formula. So, mass is 234 divided by 30, that is the volume. We'll get a value of 7.8 gram per centimeter cube. Okay. From here, now we have to convert. We have find out the value of the density from there. Now we will convert it into kg per meter cube because we have found out in gram per centimeter cube. Now we can always write this gram per centimeter cube as 7.8 into 1 gram per centimeter cube because with every value there is a 1 multiplied. Now in our from our previous lesson we have already learned about a value, that is 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kg per meter cube, right? We already know that. We already know that from our previous lessons. So, now we have 7.8 gram per centimeter cube. So, but how will we convert this? We multiply 7.8 into 1000. Okay? And that will give what? How much is given? 7800 kg per meter cube. And this is the answer of after converting the CGS into SI. Example number 9. Here, the density of copper is 8900 kg per meter cube. See, it is given in SI. Okay. So, what has been asked, what is the mass of 10 centimeter cube of copper? See, this is given in CGS. And what has been asked? Mass. Now, what is given? First thing first, we have to go step by step. First, we note down what is given to us. Density of the copper is given, that is also in kg per meter cube. So, we write it down first. Then, what is given? Volume. Volume is given in CGS system. Okay. Now first what we do? We convert the density into the CGS system. Okay. Now for that what we have in our previous example we have already known a relation between the kg per meter cube with the CGS system, that is gram per centimeter cube. Right. So remember that 1000 kg per meter cube is equal to 1 gram per centimeter cube, right? You remember that relation? So, what is given to us? 8900 kg per meter cube will be equal to what? 8900 divided by 1000, right? So, we cancel the zeros and here comes 8.9 gram per centimeter cube, right? So, the density in the CGS system comes in 8.9 gram per centimeter cube. Now, we start from here, okay? So, the volume is given in centimeter cube and the density we have found out in gram per centimeter cube. Now, we'll find the mass because mass is what has been asked. Now, we know that density is equals to mass per volume, right? Now, this is given and it has been asked. Convert this mass equals to density into volume, okay? So, on finding mass, put the value of the volume and density. Density is equals to 8.9 and volume is equals to 10. So, that is 89 gram. Here we get the mass of ours. Okay? So, this is the answer for the mass that has been asked in example number 9. So, with this class ended and we see you in the next video. So, thank you for watching.